फाइव सेकेंड, टू सेकेंड, रेडी। दिस सेमिनार टू डिस्कस पार्लियामेंट्री डेमोक्रेटिक फॉर्म्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट इज अ वेरी गुड मूव। आई हैव लुक्ड एट द हेड्स ऑफ डिस्कशन ऑन विच पेपर्स हैव बीन रिसीव्ड। दे आर इंटरेस्टिंग एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ पार्लियामेंट्री डेमोक्रेसी, बट इट सीम्स टू मी दैट दे डील विद समवाट सुपरफिशियल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द क्वेश्चन। डेमोक्रेसी एज अ स्पीकर जस्ट नाउ सेड इज अ मीन्स टू एन एंड। वाट इज द एंड वी एम एट? आई डू नॉट नो इफ एवरीबडी विल एग्री विद मी, बट आई वुड से द एंड इज द गुड लाइफ फॉर द इंडिविजुअल। वाट फॉर्म इट शुड टेक कैन बी आर्ग्यूड अबाउट, बट द गुड लाइफ सर्टेनली मस्ट इम्प्लाई अ सर्टेन सेटिस्फैक्शन ऑफ द एसेंशियल इकोनॉमिक नीड्स विच विल रिलीज हिम फ्रॉम कंटिन्यूअस ऑपरेशन एंड विच विल गिव हिम अ चांस टू डेवलप हिज क्रिएटिव फैकल्टीज। पार्लियामेंट्री डेमोक्रेसी इज अ ग्रोथ ऑफ द लास्ट 150 आर 200 ईयर्स। वी मस्ट रिमेंबर दैट इवन इन इंग्लैंड द फ्रेंचाइज वॉज स्ट्रिक्टली लिमिटेड टिल रिसेंटली। 20 or 30 years ago, a small percentage of the population had the vote. Even now, in quite advanced countries, women who form half the population do not have the vote. Democracy in those countries is presumably male democracy. It needed many struggles before democracy in the 19th century could widen out from the strict confines of certain classes. As the franchise was extended, the representatives chosen also ceased to belong to the higher classes. It is only in the last 30 years or so that adult franchise has come into being in a number of countries. This period is not long enough really to tell us what the ultimate effects of the universal franchise are likely to be in solving problems. Problems are solved not merely by the governmental structure being good, but by the quality of human beings, their education, and their character. The machine can at best make it easier for those qualities to develop and remove any elements which suppress growth. In the past, democracy has been taken chiefly to mean political democracy, roughly represented by the idea of every person having a vote. It is obvious that a vote by itself does not mean very much to a person who is down and out and starving. Such a person will be much more interested in food to eat than in a vote, his democratic right. Therefore, political democracy by itself is not enough, except that it may be used to obtain a gradually increasing measure of economic democracy. The good things of life must become available to more and more people and gross inequalities must be removed. That process has no doubt gone on for some time in countries where there is political democracy. One of the basic revolutions of the world has been the Industrial Revolution, which has changed the texture of human life. But people's minds lag behind events. Sometimes the person who considers himself most revolutionary is very conservative, that is, he holds on to things regardless of the changing conditions. The French Revolution came with a mighty bang, frightened Europe, and created innumerable waves of thought which affected Europe for almost the next 100 years. Again and again, in the rest of Europe, there were waves of revolutions following the ideas of the French Revolution, but they ended up as petty revolutions. Even the French Revolution, when it occurred, was rather out of date in the sense that something bigger was happening behind it, the Industrial Revolution. The leaders of the French Revolution were hardly conscious of the Industrial Revolution that was in its early stages. They were thinking mainly of political problems. For a considerable time after the French Revolution, while the Industrial Revolution was working its mighty change, the thinking of people was governed by the slogans and ideas of the French Revolution. Something big has happened in the structure of human life with the coming of atomic energy. We may take this as the consummation of the industrial age. It forces us to decide how we are going to use this mighty power. Rightly or wrongly, in conflict or in cooperation, all this should really force us to think on entirely new lines. We have to decide how to face these problems and not continue to think of petty matters. We believe in democracy. Speaking for myself, I believe in it first of all because I think it is the right means to achieve ends and because it is a peaceful method. Secondly, because it removes the pressures which other forms of government may impose on the individual. It transforms the discipline which is imposed by authority largely to self-discipline. Self-discipline means that even people who do not agree accept solutions because it is better to accept them than to have conflict. It is better to accept them and then change them if necessary by peaceful methods. Therefore, democracy means to me an attempt at the solution of all the economic and socio problems by peaceful methods.